liver battery both sides. Very nice. So therefore you get cosine x equals to 1/3. Therefore, one more step, Priscilla, what do we do after this? No, cannot. Oh, we made arc cosine, is it? Not now. There's several steps before that.
We don't arc cosine yet.
Not now. Jeffrey, we did this in math and at math, you know? Not yet.
Oh. Times 3.
Chi can help.
Y equals to 1 over
3. Y equals to? 1 over 3. No.
Boy. We draw.
No.
You sub in.
Huh?
You sub in X.
No. Zoe? Yes, people. Look at this. 0 to 360, right? How many quarters do we have?
Four.
Add sugar to coffee, right?
What the hell is
all
sugar to coffee?
Or all students take cocaine.
Oh, okay.
Hey, people.
Hello.
Always check out for the sign. Cosine is what here?
Positive.
So meaning which quadrant?
One and four.
One and four. So, cannot forget. I can guarantee you this will come out on us. Quarter one, draw. Quarter four, draw. After D, we have A, right?
Yeah.
So now,
yeah.
A. Now only you can arc cosine it. Now, remember when I would like to arc cosine, let's say this is negative, can I write negative?
No.
It's always positive, yeah? Look, I've always looked for...
basic angle.
Yes. A cute one, that's why it's positive. Can you tell me arc cosine, 1/3 you get what? Five. Hi, people. Now, Junchi, I hope you remember already. This is my alpha. My alpha is my basic angle. But I don't want that. I want my theta, right? Here. So meaning x is?
70.
Yes, it's the same thing. So I want this. Remember, it's always measured from positive x-axis. Always from 0. So now, if alpha is 70.5, what do you think my x is?
360 minus 70.5.
Wait lah, bro.
360
minus 70. Yes, 360 the whole thing minus 70.5, which is? Which is?
289.5.
Guys, good practice, yeah? Please write down, summarize it. 70.5, 289.5. Thank you, Raja. Okay?